Lauren, welcome. First, just what an incredible few days since you played that game. And the outpouring of support you've gotten has been amazing. I want to play everyone a clip of you addressing the crowd after you played.
Today's been the best day I've ever had. Thank you guys so much.
And that feeling out on the court as you were standing there, what was that like?
It was the best feeling in the world, because I was a little bit worried if I'd be standing or talking or able to play the game at all. But I was there and I got to play, and it was just the best moment ever.
And that's what I think a lot of people don't realize. This was extremely special for you, but it wasn't easy for you by any stretch. Can you just describe some of the symptoms that you deal with as you try to get through everyday life, much less actually trying to play basketball?
Dizziness. Like right now, sitting here talking, my whole right side is very heavy. I feel like there's like a tractor sitting on this side, and it's really hard to lift my hand, and I go through a lot of joint pain.
This has been going on for a while. When did you first start to feel sick?
I first started feeling sick my senior year of basketball. I was very dizzy and disoriented, and the left side of my tongue went numb.
So you go to the doctor, you get diagnosed, and they tell you, there's nothing we can do, it's inoperable. How do you even deal with that?
I mean, when they tell you you have an abnormality in your brain, even that just, it pulled the rug out from underneath my feet. And I hit the ground and I was breathless for a couple seconds. The hardest part is probably been these past couple weeks since my last MRI, because my tumor grew, and then they changed my prognosis again and said that I probably wouldn't make it past Christmas. But then I just picked right back up again and started asking questions, because that's kind of how I that's how I am. I'm more of a scientific mind. And then, of course, my question of the day was, can I still play basketball?
There were so many people who wanted to see you play. First, they had the game in a 2,000-seat arena. Then they moved it to a 10,000-seat arena, and tickets still sold out in less than an hour.
I remember my dad coming in and saying that the tickets were sold out. And I remember going, wow. Wow. And like looking around and just kind of like walking around my house, and that was the only word I could say was wow. And then I'd like repeat, less than an hour. I was amazed.
And you're telling your story to hope to raise awareness. Pediatric brain cancer research is underfunded, and I know you're working with the Cure Starts Now Foundation. What do you want your legacy to be on that front?
There's families going through this, and there's kids younger than I am going through this, which is what, I mean, they're who I'm fighting for. I'm not fighting for myself. I'm fighting for little kids, because one of the tumor symptoms is that it takes their voices away and that they can't speak anymore and they can't express their symptoms or how they feel.
Well, Lauren, those kids are very, very lucky to have you speaking for them. We just want to thank you so much for joining us. You have so many people rooting for you.
Thanks. I can't believe how many people are rooting for me.
It's a lot, trust me.
Thank you.